This is the second part of how to replicate setting menu of this Stickfight game. In this part, we will learn how to create these beautiful toggle button. And if you haven't watched the first part, you will get the link from the top right corner. So without wasting any time, let's start this video. Now let's change these button to some toggle which you will generally see on iPhone. We will try to replicate that toggle and it will look good also. Now inside the setting game object, I will delete all these buttons. Let's change the setting game object to true. And inside the setting game object, I will create an empty game object. I will make some adjustment in this game object. Now inside the setting game object, I will create an empty game object. I will stretch it so that it will hold all the toggle button inside this, and I will name it holder group. And inside this, I will create an empty game object and music. And inside this game object, I will create a text. I will rename it to music. I will change the font size. I will move it up. And I will change the alpha value of the setting so that we can see the text. And inside this, I will write music. Now inside the music holder, I will create an empty game object and I will name it toggle. I will change the size of this. And inside this toggle, I will create an image. I will press Ctrl Alt and select it so that it will stretch. I will rename this image to background. I have created a toggle background. I will drag and drop this toggle background in this project. And I will drag and drop this toggle background on this image. And inside this, I will again create an image. I will move it in the center. And I will change the color. I will move it right. When the toggle button is pressed, we want this handle to move from left to right or from right to left. Now let's create a C# script for this toggle. I will name it toggle UI simple. And inside the toggle game object, I will again create an image. I will stretch it. And I will add the button script to it. I will change the alpha value to 0 so that it is not visible. I will rename it to button. And I will drag and drop the toggle UI simple script on toggle game object. Now inside the script, we have to write the functionality that when we click on this button, the handle will move from left to right or from right to left. And we will also change the text from on to off or from off to on. Let's see how we will do that. I will create a public bool variable and I will name it isOn. And I will create a game object variable and I will name it handle. We have to take the rect transform of this handle game object. I will name it handle transform. I will create a handle size float variable. This will store the half of the size of this handle. And I will create a rect transform of toggle. And I will create two float variable. One is on position X and off position X. These will store the on and off position of the handle. And I will create a handle offset variable. And if you want to add the border to your toggle button, you have to change this. Now we have to create two game objects. One is on icon and other is off icon. Let's create one more variable. I will name it move speed. This is the speed you want the handle should move from left to right or from right to left. I will create a float variable, that is t. This is for internal purpose. I will create a switching bool variable, and when we press a button, we will change this bool variable to true. And inside the awake method, we have to take the rect transform of the handle game object and provide that value to the handle transform. The handle size will be the size delta of that handle transform. Now I will create a toggle size variable, and I will store the value of the toggle size delta x in this variable. And on position x value will be the half of the toggle size x value minus half of the handle size value, which give the center point of these two game objects. And if you want to add the handle offset, we will minus it by the handle offset. And off position x will be the minus value of on position x. Now inside the start, if the toggle icon is on, we will provide the on position x value to the handle transform.localPosition. And I will show the on icon and I will hide the off icon. For the off, I will copy and paste this and I will change on position x to off position x, and I will show the off icon and I will hide the on icon. Now inside the update, if switching is true, we will call a method. We have to create this method, and inside this I will provide the isOn value. And to generate a method, I will hold Ctrl plus dot. It will automatically generate this method. I will delete this line of code and I will change the toggle to T status. And first we will check if both the icon is off, and if both the icon is off, I will show the on icon. And if T status is true, I will provide the local position value. We have to create the smoothly move method. And for the smoothly move, I will provide the handle position X and off position X value. And if the T status is on, that means we are transitioning from on state to off state. So I will show the off icon and I will hide the on icon. Else, I will copy and paste this inside this. And I will change the on position X to off position X and off position X to on position X. That means we are transitioning from off position to on position. And I will show the on icon and I will hide the off icon. Now let's generate this method. I will change this to start position X and end position X. Now inside this smoothly move method, we have to loop from one value to another. So I will create a vector 3 position variable. And inside this, I will call vector 3.loop. And the start position will be start position X and end position will be end position X. and for the time I will write time equal to time plus move speed into time dot delta time, so that it will smoothly move from one state to another. Now after this we have to call a method which will stop the switching, and we will return the position value. Now let's create that method. I will create a stop switching method. I will call this method from smoothly move, and inside the stop switching method, if t is greater than 1, we will change the switching to false, and I will change the t to 0. And I will use the switch statement, and the condition will be is on. There will be two cases, if it is true or false, and if is on is true, I will change it to false, and if is on is false, I will change it to true. I will write break so that it will exit the loop when one of the condition is true. Now this script is ready. Let's go to Unity and check this. For the handle, we have to drag and drop the handle. I will rename the image to handle, and I will drag and drop that game object. We have to create the on and off icon, and I will write the move speed to 3. Let's create an empty game object. I will move it down. I will press T on the keyboard and change the size, and inside this game object I will create a text max pro text. I will change it to on. I will center it, and I will change the font asset. I will rename it to off. I will duplicate it and rename it to on, and I will change the value to on. Now let's drag and drop on game object to on game object, and off game object to off game object. Now let's get back to the editor. We have to make the toggle variable to public so that we can drag and drop the toggle game object. I will change it to public. I will save it and go to Unity. I will drag and drop the toggle game object, and it will take the rect transform of this game object. And when this button is clicked, I want to call the switch method of the toggle script. I will change the alpha value, and I will off the game object. Now let's run this application. When I click on this setting button, the setting screen should appear. The toggle button is working, that is great. We have to add the offset. So let's change the handle offset, and I want the handle offset in the negative direction. Now let's test again. Now this is looking good. You can change the move speed. Now in the game there are different type of toggle. One for the music, one for the SFX, one for the weather. So let's create that. I will go on the holder game object, and I will add the horizontal layout group. And I want this game object to have a gap in the left direction. Now I can simply duplicate it, and it will align perfectly. I will change it to sound, and I will change the other one to SFX. I will change the text of these as well. Now this is looking good. Thank you so much for recreating this with me. Recently I have published a game, and if you want to support me, you can download that game. And if you like that game, you can share it with your friends. As an indie developer, this is the only thing I can do. I don't have a marketing budget, and if you want me to play your game or test your game, you can share the link in the comment, or you can message me on my Facebook. and I am planning to create a 30-day task for you guys that will make you a better programmer. You can share your views regarding this. If you have any marketing tips which you want to share, you can share it with me. Thank you so much for supporting me, guys. And if you like the video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. See you in the next video.